Speaking of feeling alive, let's take our Forever 21 leather jackets off. Anyways, there was a made-for-TV movie based on a true story called David. Anybody familiar? Really? I looked it up on IMDb. There's a couple made-for-TV movies named David, but shout out Hi Ho Tinkles if this is the one. You might get a better song out of it. Anyways, what happened was is that little David's parents got a divorce. That's not where the story ends. His mother got a new boyfriend, and his dad did not. His father was very, very jealous, and so he decided to take David on a fun trip to Disneyland. David had always wanted to go to Disneyland. It was his dream. So his dad flew him across the country, and in the motel, the night before Disneyland, his dad said, "David, how many rides do you want to go on tomorrow?" And David said, "25. His dad said, "Well, listen here. You can go on 26 if you take this." And he held up what I now know to be a sleeping pill, because I'm friends with people that take those. David was a good boy and he wanted to go on 26 rides. He took the sleeping pill, he fell asleep, and then his dad got out 3 cans of kerosene from his trunk, dumped them all over David's bed in the motel room, threw a match into the mix, and just ran out. Always be in a relationship. That's the best advice I've ever given. Whoops. Nobody thought that David was going to live. 99% of his body is covered in third-degree burns. And they had to cover him with pigskin and cadavers. Now, he goes by the name Dave Dave, and a lot of Michael Jackson fans think that Michael Jackson faked his own death and is now walking around as Dave Dave because they look very similar. That is the good news. The bad news is that after I watched this, I became terrified of dads. Never tried to set fire to any of his children. But I was terrified when he would come to tuck me in at night. I was like, "All right, Erin, if he makes you any awesome promises, just beware, you're about to get burned." But luckily for me, he never made a single awesome promise. What he did do was right before he shut the door, he said, "Nighty-nighty, don't let the bed bugs bite you. And if they do, hit them with a shoe. You bet your sweet patooties." What I got, you gon' want get some. book. Girl, that's only if you ain't scared. Cause I won't knock or ring no bell. You just poke your bottom up in the air. I'll get you high, I know you oh so well. When I walk in, all that I a really good day at work.